So, hey, awesome ones. I know it's been a roller coaster ride for 2020, and a lot of us are thinking, hey, how am I going to get through Christmas? How am I going to enjoy Christmas? How am I going to have any magic in Christmas when I'm not seeing my family, I'm social distancing, I have no budget? And in one of the previous videos, I talked about how our street was having this kind of a street party, social distancing, and everybody was encouraged to light up their homes and give to the toy drive and, you know, give to also the food banks, and it happened. So I've got 7 ideas for you in addition to these ones, and I took some videos, so I'm going to share those with you. And this video is really about bringing some magic back into Christmas in 2020. So I hope you enjoyed that little snippet there, because it kind of reminds me of the olden days, you know, when there wasn't online shopping or malls and all that sort of thing, and how a lot of people, they just enjoyed themselves simply and merrily, even though we're not in many cases seeing our families. I just wanted to sort of get back and maybe do a reset to a simpler time. This whole video idea kind of started when I received this piece of paper here, and it was about lighting up our street. And we did have this happen last weekend, and it was absolutely beautiful. Everybody came out. Actually, the rain stopped exactly at 4:30, and this whole thing was supposed to go on from 4:30 to 8:30, so it was simply magical. And although we have downsized our home, I thought to myself, well, these are really little homes here. How's anybody going to do anything? But here's a little video, I guess a vignette, of some of the homes and some of the fun that was going on. So my second idea is to get all bundled up and go for a walk to the other streets, you know, maybe some of the bigger homes with big decorations and that sort of thing. And don't forget to maybe, this is one of those thermos mugs where I might put a cup of coffee or a cocoa or something like that in there for the walk. And take a look at the stores and maybe even the department stores. Even if they're closed up right now, they still have their windows going. And of course, one of my favorite places in this next vignette is to go to the nearby church and take a look at the nativity scene. So let's take a look at some of the decorations. So tip number 3 is, if you're one of the lucky ones, remember the spirit of giving, and you don't have to give a lot. I'm just going to show you a little clip here, because this is the overflow that I had of canned goods in my home. You know, remember when this all started, we went ahead and bought a bunch of canned goods. Well, you know, if you've got surplus, if you have even more toilet paper and paper towels and they're just sort of in the basement somewhere, grab them. And a lot of the fire halls, they're taking donations for the food banks, or maybe there's a local drive that you can find on the internet. But if you can give anything right now, and diapers, that's another thing that a lot of people need. But if you can give something, give what you can, and every little bit helps. So tip number four, still in the spirit of giving, take a look at these little teddy bears that I gave away to the toy drive. They're just sitting here and waiting for some lovely child to give them a great big cuddle and a great big hug, and that's my hope for them anyway. And you know what? In the grocery stores, I found that there were lots of teddy bears that you could purchase, and the gifts, the toy drives, they need to be a toy that is unwrapped, so that's very, and of course new. And if you don't know where to take them, just again look on the internet, and I'm sure you find a place where you can just kind of drop them off. So I've given you some scenic and some giving ideas, but what about the get-togethers? How are we going to get together with our family and our friends when we can't have them into our homes? And that's where number five, Zoom and Skype, comes in. You know, it's such an amazing thing to get everybody together. And if you don't know how to do Zoom or Skype, just ask one of your kids or a neighbor, or just go online. You can learn a YouTube video will tell you how to do it. It's fantastic. And what we've done, our kids are all over the place. They're like thousands of miles away. And what we're going to do at 1 p.m. on Christmas Day, we're going to have them all together on a Zoom meeting. And that's four kids and probably four dogs and also Bill and myself. And I got to tell you, for my sixth tip, sitting there looking at each other on a Zoom meeting, it kind of gets boring after a while. So I'm going to make sure too I wear like one of my ugly or funny Christmas sweaters. But you know, how do you keep the conversation going? Because it just kind of goes into a lull. So what I came up with was 12 family history questions. And what we're going to do, and the kids all know about this, they think it's fun, we're going to have 12 questions on family history. So one of the questions could be, hey, the last time we went to Florida, what was the name of the hotel chain that we stayed in? And everyone who gets the answer first, they get $5. And what I'm going to do at the end is I'm just going to wire everybody the money. And I also made sure that there's questions in there that every kid would know. So one of them could be a personal achievement that one of the kids did, and you know, to find the answer to that. And that way everybody wins money. And I mean, Christmas is not about the money, but you want to have some fun. And this is kind of like playing a game of Scrabble or playing a game of Family Feud or something like that that we used to do at Christmas time. And it's just a way to keep it going and keep it fun. So for the next tip, it's not too late to still send out Christmas cards. And the thing about Christmas cards is it seems to be a lost art. I mean, every year I get less and less. That doesn't sound right, but anyway, you know, people stop sending Christmas cards. They would do maybe an email open or something like that. And I just think having a card sent to you and putting it on the mantle and taking a look at it, it's just so heartwarming. And you know, if you are going to send a Christmas card, just don't sign it. Maybe put a little note in it and wish them a wonderful 2021 and hope that they're keeping safe and that the whole family is healthy. Or even put a little letter in there, a handwritten letter. Just make it personal. And a lot of people would just be so excited not to see another, you know, bill in their mail, but to see a beautiful Christmas card. And here's some of the Christmas cards that I bought this year. I actually bought a few more, but I've already sent them out. And don't forget to do something that's funny, because laughter is always the best medicine. And what do you think of this card? And I would love to hear what your ideas are, you know, to help 2020 be a great holiday season and Christmas time. And just put in the comments, you know, maybe your favorite cookies for Christmas, what you love to bake, what you love to cook. And this is such a great community. I just love you all here. And I just love to share things and know that you're sharing with other people. And it is the best place for that. So as I introduce little Hurricane here, happy holidays, everyone. I just wonder, aww. This is what I actually want to talk about. I want to talk about your attitude of gratitude and looking after yourself. You know, you need to have some self-care, especially when it's crazy and you're worried and there's so many things on your mind. You know, take a deep breath. Remember the spirit of the season, and to remember to take care of yourself, because you are one of the awesome ones. And at this point, I just want to say, keep the magic of Christmas in your heart, take care of yourself, and of course, keep it awesome.